energy healing work and intuitive readings. Mavi facilitates healing, transformation, and personal empowerment. So please help me welcome Mavi Helmer.
Thank you very much. First of all, thanks for coming over. And since we don't have so much time, already she made this introduction, we're going to talk about what twin meditation is about. Twin meditation has a lot of beneficial powers, if you want to say, such as it can affect your well-being, it can help you to heal in the emotional level as well, and it can help you to integrate, especially the energies that are coming this way during these times. Okay? So it's a very simple technique. It was developed. This particular version that we're going to do is presented by Master Choa Coxley. He's a master. He developed this technique on pranic healing. I don't know if anybody have heard pranic healing. Yeah, you have? Very good. So many people are getting a lot of benefits while doing this meditation. And I find it myself, through my own experience, very, very beneficial. Extremely beneficial, and it doesn't take too long either. This particular, it only takes 5 minutes. With that being said, we're going to do the following. Number one, we're going to relax. It's very important. So all it takes is Archana. She's a leader also here from Pranic Healing. She has a book here from Pranic Healing. This is Archana. She will lead us through some meditation, some loosening up the body exercises. We all need to move so the energy can flow better for this particular meditation. Okay? So do you want to go ahead and help us out? So do you want to stand up? But also if she wants, she can add a few things.
Go ahead. So the energy is very heavy, very strong when you activate the heart and the palm. So what we want to do is loosen up a little bit so that the energy can flow through smoothly. So if you want to stand up and do simple exercises with me, we roll our eyes off our chest. So one. To the upper body twist. Go all the way as much as you can. This is very good for releasing any stress in the solar plexus. We're basically trying to move all the major energy centers when we're doing these exercises. Hip rotations, clockwise first. We do clockwise first to release any excess energy and counterclockwise to absorb fresh energy.
Very good. You're all doing so good.
So close to the front and the right,
yes.
And to the right.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. To the right. Yes.
Very good.
And then counterclockwise.
The other side. Just move the hips. Allow them to relax. Make your body very flexible.
Some squats.
Some squats?
Simple bounces.
Very important.
the time that you're doing these exercises, you can have a big, big smile on your face.
Of course!
It helps a lot.
That's it. Good.
Now we'll take shoulders backwards first. Hands are nice, tired.
Are you already feeling good?
Yeah.
I hope so. This is only the beginning, because at the end you will be transformed and be floating. I'm just kidding. Are you well? Very good.
Take your arms.
Release the tension of the arms.
Yeah, it's very similar.
Yeah, just enough. So the energy can flow better through our hands. Very good.
Reflexes.
Yeah. Think you're kicking your husband, your wife. No, I'm just kidding. Relax, happy, connecting with the happiness in our heart, with the joy. Very good. Just do this. Releasing the ankles. And let's do the other side as well. Very good. How are you feeling? Better?
Yeah.
You can feel the energy flowing better, right?
Yeah.
Very good. So what we're going to do now, you can have a seat, please. So what we're going to do now is like really relax. What we need to do when the body is receptive is in a state of relaxation. Very, very important. You don't have to do nothing special, other than it would be a good idea. Some people feel the energy, some other ones see it, some other ones can hear voices in their head, that sort of stuff. So in this case, what we're going to do is just to warm up our hands this way, so we're receptive. We're going to press the needle in the palm of our hands like that. And we're going to make the intention, because intention is very important, right? Without intention, there's nothing. So the intention is to say, activate. Activate. Very nice. So with that being said, some people, when we do this again, you can feel the flow. If you really just start, it's kind of cold here, perhaps we'll do. Maybe some warmness, some tingling. And you can do this like she's doing already. Very good. Very good. You don't have to put your thoughts, you just there, like you're breathing. No efforts at all. Just let it go. Very good. How many of you have been able to sense the energy? Yeah, very good. Well, very nice. Okay, so I'm going to close the door. So we have some energy holding back here. Hi, how are you? Welcome. Just have a seat. So what it needs to happen between this time is try to do your the best to be super, super receptive. To what? To your inner being, to the source of life, or whatever you want to call it, okay? We're just going to make that effort to connect with that. And most of all, relax, just put your shoulders there, your hands in the palm of your legs. And we're going to cross our eyes very gently. Breathing deeply. And is all the way down. Be fully present in this moment. Take a breath, very loving breath once more. Relaxing the body if you sense any tension. What I would like for you to do now is to remember something beautiful that has happened to you at the time when you felt so joyful, so so happy. Just bring that moment into your heart. Connect to that happiness. How it made you feel. Sense your body. And I want you to expand that feeling. Very loving feeling. Easy, effortlessly. Becoming aware of breathing in. Yes. Now we're going to think of another time when we also felt so happy, so joyful. And we are going to activate the crown chakra and up to the head. Remain in that state. And now we're going to play the meditation. And we're just going to follow the steps. Like I said, the key is being very receptive. Make yourself receptive by just allowing this energy to flow through your whole being to activate your healing, to connect to your healing power. To your divine love. Very nice. We're loving very well. Let's breathe your hands.
Of your peace. Feel the inner peace within you. Allow yourself to be a channel for divine peace. Feel the peace within you. Let it flow through your heart, through your hands. Gently and lovingly share this peace with the small earth in front of you. Feel the peace.
You can raise your hands in your heart with the trust of them.
Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Feel the love within you. Allow yourself to be a channel for divine love. Feel this love within you. Feel this love flowing from your heart to your heart and to your hands, going to the small earth in front of you. Bless the earth with peace and with love. Where there is injury, pardon. Allow yourself to be a channel for divine forgiveness, divine reconciliation. The earth with the spirit of forgiveness, the spirit of reconciliation. Let there be understanding, harmony, and peace. Where there is despair, hope, doubt, faith. Allow yourself to be a channel for divine hope and divine faith. Bless the earth with hope and with faith. Bless people who are having a difficult time. Bless them with hope and with faith. Silently tell them, you can make it. Bless them with divine hope, with divine faith, with divine strength. Blessings be to all. people who are sad, people who are in pain, people who are depressed, fill them with life and joy. Be aware of your crown, the center of the crown. Imagine the small earth in front of you. And silently repeat after me. From the heart of God, let the entire earth be blessed with loving kindness. Feel the divine love and the divine kindness. Let the entire earth be blessed with great joy and happiness, with understanding, harmony, and divine peace, with goodwill and the will to do good. Imagine people are not only talking about doing something good, but actually acting out this goodness.
Continue in that state. Go even deeper into that feeling. And imagine yourself inside Mother Earth and the loved ones that you wish to have received this energy. Your family, your loved ones. Okay, coming back. Very good. Can you hear me okay? Yeah? So how are you feeling?
Good.
So how many of you were able to kind of really go deep or sense something was kind of happening within your brain? Can you lift that? Mm-hmm. Very good. Very good. So this is only the beginning, and of course this is a very short meditation time. But just imagine what you just did. What happened is that you aligned with that source of life, that energy, and you allow that energy just to come through you. And what happens when that you allow that energy, it flushes away all the stuff, yucky stuff, sort of, that we don't need. It replaces the old energy by bringing in the new energy. And by us doing this, the intention of just allowing that energy to flow, healing others, it helps us indirectly. It has many, many benefits that we all couldn't finish with this time that we have now. Perhaps Archana can let us know what are the further benefits that we receive when we do this type of meditation.
Thank you. The effect of the meditation happens in many levels. Physically, it balances on all of your hands and hormones, so a lot of the issues that you might see in general start to reduce. Like your ability to accept pain or see the way pain works is a lot better. Like your pain tolerance is higher and things like that. And emotionally, you're in a state of love and peace. Like imagine if you did that meditation every single day for 20 minutes, then you're inculcating love, peace, happiness, joy, all the good stuff, right? Now imagine a person that you don't feel very good looking at, and you want to just frown at them, you probably won't be able to. So that causes a butterfly effect, and they start to behave nicely, and they're nice to you also. So emotionally, it has benefits in terms of relationships. And also, for me, I do this meditation every day before I go to work, and I feel like the work is space is completely different. I'm able to get more things done because there's less drama, and then I'm able to think clearly, so I know which direction to take, the better decision making. Just because it is so, it's very well rounded. Like when the heart opens, the crown opens, and when the crown opens, the divine energy flows through and takes care of everything that is probably needs attention. Like the divine energy has a consciousness of its own, so it is trying to help you out, heal stuff that you are not able to probably. So it works out in different levels like that.
Yeah, absolutely. And finally, sometimes like myself, if you don't have the 20 minutes, there is a 5-minute meditation like this one. I personally can say that has helped me incredible and in a very, very nice way. Because as this is happening, we're changing our outside world. We all know this. You're already, you know, there's no need for me to go party. Just go and do it if you feel like it. You want to connect to your energy, to your divine being. And I want to just thank you very much for coming over. I really appreciate this. If you have any questions, please go ahead and ask us. We have time to talk there. Yes, sir.
They talked about the earth in front of you. Were we supposed to, you didn't explain, we were visualizing the earth in front of us, or where was it, like in front of our heart, or above our face?
Very nice. So basically, it's like, imagine the earth at this level, if you want it, the size that you want. Just visualize like they put in the pictures of NASA, you know the picture? When you're doing that, automatically you're doing to the whole earth. Makes
heart
sense?
Level, basically.
Yeah, because you're
heart.
Yes. Very good. Any other questions? Have anybody would like to share what they felt, the sense?
I have a question. So if you're interested in this twin heart meditation and you want to practice, how do you do it? Do you buy a CD? Is that, or you have to take a class, be trained, or buy a book?
I love that. Thanks for asking that. Well, there are several ways you can do it. There is a group that leads this, including free healing sessions of pranic healing. You can go there and start learning. If you're interested, you can go farther. But if you just want to do the meditation itself, you can purchase it from pranichealing.website.com. And there's plenty of information there. If you Google what the benefits of pranic healing, you can find many yourself. It's not like we're just saying, yeah, okay. You can find that information there. Archana is, I think, you are, can you, do you want to tell them where they can find you?
Yeah, we facilitate pranic healing and meditation on Twin Hearts every second and fourth Sundays at the University of Dallas. I have some flyers I can hand out to you guys. So. What we do is we do the meditation every day, every time we gather, and then we do free healings for everyone who wants to experience it. And then we do have a class coming up in the end of October if you're interested to pursue further in energy concepts.
Also, another thing that I would like to encourage is you just start and it's like, what? How in the world I can have the water in my hand right there in front of me? I mean, really? It's all about the mind and your perception. If you judge yourself, well, I'm going to do it this way, that's the way it is, just bypass the defense, you know, bypass of the mind. So just do it, like Nike says, just do it. Just look at what it counts is the intention. You just say, I just want to be this instrument and I really want to be guided and healed. Hey, anybody wants to be healed. So just open. I don't have to think, I don't need to know if it's happening or not. That's one of the things many think like, but I'm not feeling, why is that? It's not happening. You know, because we live in this reality, we need to feel, right? Kind of a slap like that. But the energy we are tuning to is very fine. It's affecting you at different levels. cannot really perceive at the moment. The more you do it, and then these gifts start opening up more and aligning you more with your higher self, which in turn helps you with the psychological, physical, and emotional healing. So we encourage you to continue with this practice whenever you can. But at least give it a chance, give it a try, okay? Thanks for coming all. Have a good one.